Hey, welcome back to No Hype Beer Reviews. Unless it's your first time, then welcome. Please consider subscribing. If you do, hit the notification bell. Get updates. We're excited for today's beer. It's courtesy of Sean from NerdSense. So thank you so much, Sean. Slow your words down. Really proud of those guys. They just hit 500 subscribers. They should have 5,000, but I'll take 500 for now. So big shout out to them. Make sure you check them out. And yeah, trying to do posting videos on Tuesdays where I kind of challenge my palate. Whether it's a mystery beer or try to drink maybe a beer that's a style I'm not used to, or I don't know, just anything that kind of challenges me in terms of drinking beer, not just doing the same old thing. I liked the last week I did a mystery beer, ended up being a Kolsch style beer, and I was really leaning into a Pilsner. Honestly, didn't know much about Kolsch. Right up on it afterwards, there's a lot of overlap with Pilsner, so I felt pretty good about that. And yeah, hoping to do well with this. Since Sean is the one who sent this, I bet you a nickel it's a Trillium beer. Let's get into it. Oh, it's a darker beer. Okay. It's like a dark cola color. Interesting. I'm gonna be bold right now. I think I get some peanut butter. So yeah, man, it's pretty darn black. I was saying dark cola, but in the glass, it is pretty darn black. Maybe just over a finger of... It's pretty darn mocha head. Small bubbles. There's some like teeny tiny at the bottom where the liquid meets the foam, but it's mostly small bubbles. There's some legs. Makes me think it's a little higher alcohol. Not really getting lacing. It kind of comes back down. But yeah, I mean, definitely looks like it's in the stout family. Let's get into the proper aroma. It has a lot of peanut butter in it. There's some chocolate, so you get a little bit of like a Reese's Pieces. The roasty, chocolatey quality. Not full on coffee, but definitely in that realm of roast. The peanut butter itself is very sweet, so it's a sweet smelling beer without being cloyingly sweet, without being full on pastry town kind of a thing, or pastry boy. Now I'm getting even more of that roast dark chocolate. I don't think it has fruit in it, but the peanut butter is kind of for like half a second making me think peanut butter jelly. But I'm thinking it's a peanut butter stout. Let's get into it. Cheers. I feel like it happens a lot where the aroma, and especially like in a lot of these New England style IPAs, will be sweeter than the taste. This one, the sweetness is about the same as the aroma, which is pretty interesting because it has not happened to me, regardless of style, it hasn't happened to me much lately. It definitely has peanut butter in it. Maybe it's just the peanut butter mixing with the stout, but it is very chocolatey. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if it has cacao nibs in it. The fullness of the... It's not full on syrupy, but it's approaching where you would start maybe saying it's light syrup. So it's getting to that level. It's coating. It's very full. There's some, you know, like I said, legs on the glass. So I'm thinking it's a higher ABV. But you don't get the taste of the alcohol. You just get a really delicious peanut butter stout. I'm thinking, just because it's Sean, it's peanut butter, there might be some coffee in it. It's going to be Trillium's Peanut Butter PM Dawn. even assuming that, I would think the ABV is around 10%, and I think that beer clocks in around 10%. I don't remember him buying it recently, but I just, knowing him and knowing how delicious this beer is, I'm thinking that's what it is. 10% peanut butter stout. Wouldn't be surprised if it has coffee or cacao nibs in it. And I said what beer I think it is anyway. Let's get into it. I like doing any kind of mystery beer, but I tell you what, when it has adjuncts in it, just for me, I think it's more fun because you're like trying to like, you know, is it blueberry or is it raspberry I'm getting? And it's like, oh man, it was cherry. Okay, well, at least I was in that realm, wherever. I just kind of like that. It's also fun to do them if it's like, you know, a hyped brewery or like just some random, you know, local brewery. And kind of like, you're like, oh, is it a good beer or not a good beer as you're doing it mystery wise. That's always kind of fun too. But anyway. Well, it's got the right color to be a PM Dawn. Peanut butter PM Dawn, American style with cold brew coffee. And it is 10.1% ABV. How fresh is it? Pretty darn fresh. Holy cow, it's not even a month old. I've had PM Dawn. I've had some of the variants. Which was the one that wasn't that... Oh, it's probably the vanilla one. Is that the one? And of course, I'm the vanilla police. There was one variant of PM Dawn that was just like, eh? Excuse me. And I think it was the vanilla. And I shouldn't say eh, but like you didn't get a lot of the adjunct, if I'm remembering correctly. And again, if I'm remembering correctly, which I'm usually not, this was one that I've had that I really liked. I'm really liking this. It is kind of like I said with the aroma, it's not full pastry stout, but like as someone who's okay going full pastry stout, but also, you know, came up on, you know, classical beers and you know, true to style. I think this is a good middle ground where it's going to scratch that itch of, oh, I like sweet stouts, especially with adjuncts. And, you know, I like a good stout, and every once in a while I like to try something a little different. I think it's, like, really good for those, like, to bridge those two mindsets. And my mindset's all over the place for just wanting to try craft beer, and I have a lot of things I like and don't like about styles and whatnot. So, yeah, I think it's very clear that I knew the beer, given context clues and the deliciousness of it and the flavors of it. And that I really like this beer, and that's also really clear. Make sure you check out Sean and Mike as well, even though he had nothing to do with this beer, and he hates coffee. So make sure you check out Nerd Sense. Make sure you check me out on Instagram and Untapped. No hype beer reviews about those places. So always please like, comment, subscribe, and most importantly, imbibe. Cheers, everyone.